There are three types of consistency. What are they? Let's find out. By the way, if you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button. Lots of great videos coming up. Don't miss out. The first type are inconsistent people. These are naturally inconsistent, yeah? And they usually have a hard time staying consistent, even if they try to. There's a very high chance you're watching this video because that's probably you. I don't think too many consistent people will watch this video, yeah? Low chance, I would say. And if you're an inconsistent person, there are usually two reasons for that. Number one, and that's the big one, it's because of your personality. Yeah, you're either a very, very results-oriented person, a goal-oriented person, so meaning you like to get things done faster, right? Have one big event and get it all done. Or you like variety. Yeah, you like to have variety. It's boring for you to do the same thing again and again and again and again. Can be a combination of both. Or, based on your personality, you're just lazy. And if you're lazy, there's nothing I can help you with. No, I'm kidding. I made a different video if you're lazy, okay? And how to overcome it as well. The second reason is your environment. If you're consistently surrounded by inconsistent people, that's a mouthful, by the way, chances are you are not very consistent. So in that case, you got to change your environment. Yeah, so that's the first type. It's inconsistent. The second type are consistent people. Right? Some people are just naturally consistent. If that is you, congratulations, because that's what everybody wants. My challenge for you though would be that usually consistent people are very good at doing things over and over and over and over consistently again and again. But sometimes the bigger issue for you is to step it up to the next level. Yeah, so that's what you want to do. The other consistent type is those who learned to be consistent. Yeah, and this works for some people, but it doesn't work for others. So watch the third type, because the third type might really be the solution for you. Type number three are inconsistently consistent people. Yeah, and this is really where, if you're watching this and you're inconsistent, that's the type you usually, I recommend you want to go for. Because the problem is that usually inconsistent people try to become like consistent people. And for most inconsistent people, it does not work. It doesn't work at all. Yeah, because you're changing your personality too much, and at some point you reach a breaking point. I'm sick and tired of all this. I don't want to be consistent anymore. This is frustrating and annoying. So what's a better way? A better way is really, you know, to use your need for variety, to acknowledge that you're inconsistent, and then use your need for variety to make you more consistent. Yeah, we got to use that to your advantage. So how can we do it? Let me give you an example. So here's a quick example. For if you're a consistent person, you go to the gym 5 days a week for 30 minutes, right? You do it again and again and again and again and again. Probably every day at the same time. Yeah, for the same period, using the same program. That's what consistent people are so amazing at. This does not work for a naturally inconsistent person. It's just not in your personality. So again, how can we use this to become inconsistently consistent? What could you do? You could, instead of going to the gym every single day, which would bore you out probably pretty quickly, yeah, instead you can do 1 day a week for 30 minutes. You either go to the gym or you do weights at home, push-ups or whatever. Yeah, that's the one thing. Then another day, in the evening maybe, you play 1 hour of tennis or 1 hour of basketball or 1 hour of whatever with your buddies. Then maybe on the weekend, maybe on a Saturday morning, you join a runner club and you go jogging for about an hour with that group. Yeah. Can you see how that really plays to your need for variety? How you're kind of inconsistent, but over a period, you consistently exercise. And it plays to your true nature. You are more inconsistent, you need more variety, you don't want boredom, okay? Of course, a consistent person doesn't want boredom either. Yeah, but their need for that is lower than yours. You need more fun, you need more action, you need more excitement, right? And you can play to that by scheduling your week in that way. And over time, you're really, really building that habit of consistent exercise. but using your inconsistent nature. I hope this makes sense so far. Again, you want to think about how can you use the same method in all areas of your life, your career, your relationship, your health, and your personal growth, right? How could you do it? Because the key really is if you follow this, you truly, truly, truly can become inconsistently consistent. So comment down below one time, what is your natural type? Yeah, is it the first type or the second type? And if it's the first type, do you want to make the move to the third type? And how are you going to do it? Yeah, share it with me in the comments down below one time. I'm very, very interested, very, very excited. Again, I believe everybody can become more consistent, but you got to play to your true nature, to your true personality. Yeah, so, so critical. All right, so comment that down below one time. By the way, if you haven't done it yet, make sure to hit the subscribe button. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And most importantly, I really look forward to seeing you for the next video.